The IPL turns 30, the IPL 2017 turns 30 on Wednesday when Pune hosts Kolkata. And who would have thought that Pune end up being in the better run of form in the build-up to this game. Three wins on the trot. Kolkata, on the other hand, have never spent lesser time on a field with the ball in hand. They have with the bat in hand. Akash Chopra was part of that team that got dismissed for 63. Now doesn't need to worry about that record because no one's going to remind him of it.
Thank you.
Because
even
that belongs,
though you have. But
that
anyway.
Belongs to RCB now, 49 all out. And Brad Hogg, always a pleasure. We're going to talk about Pune and Kolkata, who I think you guys have picked your colours wisely for. Let's get straight into match day, match point number one. And we must speak of the one man who's quietly done a job that has gone unnoticed because of the eventual result and the manner in which you can credit Ben Stokes for one, MS Dhoni for another. But Manoj Tiwari's resurgence as a player. As a player who was touted up to be the next big thing in Indian cricket, injuries and all that. And now the IPL 2017 has made us see the best of Tiwari, striking at 167, whereas in all the time, and he's played a good number of IPL cricket, gents, 68 innings, strike rate of 113, gets the boundary even when he's sent in the last three or four overs, and an average of 45 sees. He's done quite the job. Let's get Akash Chopra first on what you can attribute this resurgence of Manoj Tiwari to. 45 seconds, Akash, for you to tell me what.
Oh, well, a good domestic season for starters. And then at times you come off age. I think Manoj Tiwari looks like someone who's come off age. And also, it's not just his strike rate in this IPL with regards to his other teammates. It's just head and shoulders above the rest. And therefore, I actually think that he must be batting higher up in the order. And the moment 10-over mark is done, just send in Manoj Tiwari because in T20 cricket, form is gold. If it's there, use it.
With plenty of time to spare. So who would fall below the order then, logically?
It could be anybody. I really don't. That's a minor concern for me as far as RPS batting lineup is concerned. If the moment you hit that 10-over mark, get Manoj Tiwari in because he's not a floater. He's not a slogger. He's a batsman who has scored centuries in first-class cricket. He's got a one-day 100 as well. So he can bat. So just trust. Put some trust in him.
Yeah. Okay, let me move from the batsman to the slogger. And
I don't like
due respect.
That. I do not like that.
No. I will rephrase that. Brad Hogg, the all-rounder. Let's move from the batsman to the all-rounder.
Disrespectful.
Manoj Tiwari, Hoggy. Looking at the resources Pune have, Dhoni, Ben Stokes, where would you think would be the optimum use of Tiwari, who's actually striking it better, dare I say, than MS Dhoni and Stokes, even at the death?
Well, I think Tiwari should definitely bat out number four. Simple as that. He's the one that's in form. Stokes, Dhoni are just too slow with the bat and just can't get any rhythm at the moment. So he's got to come in earlier than what he is. The thing I like about him, he is a pure batsman. He's very busy when he comes to the crease. If he's not scoring boundaries, he's getting off strike. But when he does go for the boundary, it's not chasing the boundary. He plays a beautiful cricket shot. He picks the gap. And it's as simple as that. He's not really a power player. It's just the way that he finds the gaps. Brilliant player. Good. Okay. Matured.
So if you're watching RPS camp, you know where to bat Manoj Tiwari. Whoever it might be ahead of or after, bat him as high as you can.